There are many changes that have happened in this new version, and I think one of the most difficult ones for people to understand or deal with is the fact that Microsoft has changed that when you type something and you begin a new paragraph, they are adding an additional 10 spaces to the end of an existing paragraph so that it automatically looks as if there's an extra blank line that has been added between paragraphs. In the old versions of Word, I would have told people that when you type something and you're ready to start a new paragraph, you almost always press enter twice, enter, enter, and that would have added a blank line between paragraphs. That is no longer required in this new version when you type something. So I'm going to begin by simply typing something. I'm going to type in first choice travel. If I simply press enter, you can see very clearly that it moved down, started a new paragraph. And when you do that, you have quite a bit of space. It looks as if, and it does a nice separation between those paragraphs. If, though, I was doing an address for someone, I wouldn't want that extra space. So I have, as you well know with Microsoft, more than one option for how I can change that. I'm going to backspace, move myself back up there, and a quick and easy way of moving down without adding that extra space is to move down by adding a line break instead of a paragraph break. So a paragraph break again says to Word, I'm starting a new paragraph. A line break says, I don't want anything else on this line, but I'm not going to start a new paragraph. Continue in this paragraph, but break to a new line. And that would be rather than simply pressing enter, if you press shift and enter, it moves down without adding that additional space. And then I could continue with my address. And again, a shift enter. And if I wanted to start a paragraph now, I would press a regular enter. So to stop that extra space, one of the things you can do is a line break instead of a paragraph break. I have continued by typing a paragraph, and I want you to look at the paragraph that I've typed because there is also a change in this new version. What Microsoft has done is they've updated the way that we type things, and very specifically, the way that we are looking and using information. We no longer primarily print everything that we do. Many of the things that we do now are used on the screen, and they're read on a computer screen. So what has happened is now we have changed this so that no longer do you we expect you to be printing it and reading it on a piece of paper, but the formatting and things that we're doing and using to create documents, the defaults have been changed to work better for reading them on a screen. What I was just referring to was the fact that the new default font in Microsoft Word is Calibri and the size is 11 point. In addition to that, where I would like you to look is in the paragraph group also. So I'm looking here in the paragraph group, and when I do that, what I would like you to do is to actually find for me the button in the paragraph that refers to line spacing. Now, Microsoft provides a very effective way of helping you with that. Notice that if you simply take your mouse and hold still on any one of the buttons, you will get a drop-down box that opens up and tells you exactly what that button does. So it's not that you have to memorize each one. If you take your mouse and hold still on each one of those buttons, eventually you'll find the one that's for line spacing, which I'm showing you here. When you see that line spacing button, read the information that pops down. It tells you that it changes the spacing between the lines of text, and also that using this, I can customize the amount of space added before and after paragraphs. So this one button will do more than one thing. As you look at the paragraph down below, this big paragraph that I've typed in, You may or may not be aware, but there's a little bit of extra space than there used to be in the olden days, the older version of Microsoft Word. The font is a little bit smaller, but with the extra space that's added between each lines of the paragraph, it makes it very easy for me to read that. The space specifically is 1.15, and I'll see that if I go to the line spacing button. Notice it has an arrow pointing down just to the right of it, telling me that if I click on it, it will give me that drop-down list of choices, and I see the check mark is placed in 1.15, indicating that that's the current line spacing. In the older version of Excel, it was single sp or one space, and if I click on that, because this was the active paragraph, it pushed those lines a little bit closer together. I'm going to undo that, and I do think it's easier to read with that little bit of extra space between those lines. As you work in Microsoft Word, you may find that you aren't sure when you look back at something how it got to be the way that it is. So what I'd like you to do is turn on a feature called Show Hide. And that is located in the Home tab, Paragraph Group, and it is right here, this little paragraph symbol. If you click on it, what you're going to see is that it shows you a dot every time you press the space bar. When you do a line break, it has this little curved arrow, so you can see where I press the Shift Enter at the end of each of these. And then this is a paragraph mark. So when I got done typing travel package, rather than doing a line break, I pressed enter, which added that extra space. And you can see at the end of these lines, there is no break. I allowed the computer to decide when my line should end, and it did the word wrapping for me. When you get to the end of each paragraph, then you would again have the option of entering and starting a new paragraph. I don't notice the show hide being on. It kind of drives people crazy sometimes, but I'm going to encourage you to leave that on. Especially other things, you're going to find that that's really going to help you. So let's try to get used to that being on